Hello, Stuart Carey here with Parkway Church with the word for your Wednesday. In last week's edition, I spoke of the importance of truthfulness with our words. Today, I would like to take a look at honesty through our actions, operating with integrity in our dealings and interactions with others. I once read of a farmer who weekly was selling a pound of butter to a local baker. After several weeks of purchasing the pound of butter from the farmer, one day the baker decided to weigh the portion of butter to ensure that he was receiving a full pound. When he placed the butter on his scale, quickly to his dismay, he noticed that the butter fell several ounces shy of 16. The baker, feeling as if he was being cheated, became enraged and eventually took the farmer to court over this issue. When the court date came, the judge simply asked the farmer one question: how are you measuring the butter that you are selling to the baker? The farmer responded by saying, "Your Honor, I am a poor man and I do not have an exact measuring tool, but I do, however, have a scale." He said, "You see, I have been purchasing a 1 pound loaf of bread from the baker weekly for far longer than he's been buying butter from me. Each week when the baker brings my bread, I place the loaf on my scale, and whatever the exact weight of the loaf happens to be, that is exactly what I weigh out in butter to give him in return." So to sum it all up, if the baker is not receiving a pound of butter, then he is not giving a pound of bread as he promised. There are several takeaways from this illustration today. Of course, the most obvious being, and truthfully, you will get what you give. If you intend or fall into the practice of aiming to cheat others, you yourself will eventually be cheated. But when we operate in honesty and in integrity, we are able to trust others and not have to live in a constant state of suspicion over who may be out to get us. You see, also, when we operate in honesty, not only will people trust us, but we can have more confidence in them as well. The Word of God has much to say about honesty. In Luke chapter 6 and verse number 31, we read words that most of us have heard many times throughout our lives: "Do to others as you would have them do to you." In Proverbs chapter 10 and verse number 9, we're told that whoever walks in integrity walks securely, but whoever takes crooked paths will be found out. In the illustration that I shared concerning the farmer and the baker, this is absolutely a case where if one had done unto the other what they expected to be done unto them, there would have been no issue here. You see, the baker's greed revealed his own deceit. But on the other side of the coin, the farmer, even though he discovered the discrepancy first, could have chosen to take the high road and what would have pleased God in continuing to provide the full amount of butter, even though he was being slighted on the bread. The baker was simply reaping what he had sown. You see, operating with integrity is what you do. It's behaving honestly when no one else is looking. As Christians, God has called us to operate in integrity. We are to be people who can be trusted, and not only that, but able to trust others to affect them for the Lord Jesus Christ. So today, I encourage you to be more concerned about being a blessing to others and blessing them rather than being concerned about what you're receiving in return. Because you see, even if others are not honest with us, God makes up the difference when we operate with integrity and we are honest with them. I hope that this has been a blessing to you today. And if it has, please share this video with someone else. As always, please feel free to post your prayer requests in the comments below. We would love to know about you and your situation and not only pray with you, but pray for you. Remember that Parkway Church loves you, Brother Stuart Carey loves you, and most of all, the Lord Jesus Christ loves you. I bless you today in Jesus' name.